Hello guys, this is Ravens from Digi Integrity. Today we are going to see some interesting tech news in episode 176. Reliance Jio has tied up with 5 banks to finance the sale of upcoming smartphone JioPhone Next. JioPhone Next buyers will reportedly have to pay 10% of the cost upfront, with lenders financing the remaining amount. Reliance Jio has partnered with smartphone companies for Jio-exclusive smartphones. While Reliance is set to launch its new Google-backed 4G smartphone JioPhone Next, which is on September 10th. JioPhone Next will reportedly be available in 2 variants, the basic variant and an advanced variant, which will be priced under ₹10,000. New Jio Disney Plus Hotstar plans have been announced. These plans comes with a Disney Plus Hotstar mobile subscription bundle for free. The new Jio recharge plans will come into force starting from tomorrow. Please check out the screen for the details about the Jio plans. Tim Cook might be stepping down as an Apple CEO sometime after 2025. He is likely to expand Apple's portfolio to include AR/VR hardware before stepping down as CEO. Apple might already be working on the plan, with its mixed reality headset set to debut sometime next year. Tesla is closer to making its official debut in India after it received approval to make or import 4 models in the South Asian nation. Tesla has added vehicles certified as being roadworthy in India, a posting on the website of the Ministry of Road Transport and Highway has showed. The test ensures the vehicle matches the requirement of an Indian market in terms of emission and safety and roadworthiness. According to the leaks, the cars may be a Model 3 and Model Y variants. Instagram has announced that it will be start promoting users to fill their birthday details. These prompts can initially be dismissed, but the social media giant looks to make its mandate eventually to continue using Instagram. These prompts looks to understand how old everyone is on Instagram and prevent content that is not suitable for young people to appear on their feed. Instagram says that this information is necessary for new features that is developing to protect young people. Realme GT Neo Gaming Price camera setup design and variants have been leaked. If we talk about the specifications, it comes with a Qualcomm Snapdragon 870 processor and a 64MP triple camera. If we talk about the variants, it comes in a 2 different variants, 8GB RAM and a 128GB storage, that is costing us around $499, that is around 36,500 Indian rupees. For the 12GB RAM and a 256GB storage variant, that is costing us around $599, that is roughly around 43,800 Indian rupees. Realme teased the Realme 8i India launch. This handset could be the first one to come with a MediaTek Helio G96 chipset. Redmi 8i specifications could include a 6.59 inch display, 50MP camera and a 5000mAh battery. Realme 9 will launch in India in October, just ahead of Diwali. Realme 8i and AS will debut in the country in this September. This exact launch date of these phones are yet to be revealed officially. Redmi Note 10 Pro and Note 10 Pro Max get a new dark nebula color option. This new color joins the vintage bronze, glacier's blue and a dark night color variants. Redmi Note 10 Pro price starts at ₹17,999, while the Pro Max begins at ₹19,999. Xiaomi 11T and 11T Pro renders show their design will be closer to the Mi 11X than to Mi 11. The two phones will come in Metroid Grey, Celestial Blue and Moonlight White. A new white color variant of Xiaomi 11 Lite 5G is also in the works. Telegram has become the latest application to surpass the mark of 1 billion downloads globally. According to the data shared by Sensor Tower, the instant messaging application, which has been existence late since 2013, competes against WhatsApp and Facebook Messenger. It was able to grow its market presence and amid public outrage over WhatsApp recently privacy policy update. Telegram also introduced new features including a group video calls, screen sharing with sound and an updated voice chat experience that helped attract a new user. Battleground Mobile India, just like most other online multiplayer games, has a major problem, which are the people who try to cheat to gain an advantage. While they might be making a game easier for themselves, but they make the game unenjoyable for others. To keep the game fair for everyone, Crafton, under its BanPan initiative, keeps regularly banning players who have been using hacks or cheats. It publishes weekly reports on the number of banned accounts. The company has now published its 4th report for the same. The Department of Information Technology and Forest under the Telangana government has partnered with Hyderabad-based startup Marid Drones to launch a drone-based afforestation in the state under its Hara Bahara campaign. This program aims to plant 50 lakh seeds on 12,000 hectares across all 33 districts in the state. Minister of Information Technology K.T. Rama Rao said that it will be the first of its kind of project in the country. The seed copter developed by Marid Drones is an aerial seeding solution for rapid and scalable reforestation. This project uses drones to disperse seed balls over thin, barren and empty forest land to turn them into a lush green abodes of trees. The process begins with a field survey and mapping of the terrain to understand the ecosystem and demarcate the areas that need the urgent attention. This is used to determine the number and species of trees that can be planted based on the soil, climate and other parameters. New research in the sphere of rechargeable batteries has resulted in an alkali metal chlorine battery that can store up to 6 times more charge than a normal lithium-ion battery of today. This discovery was published on 25th August 2021. The team of researchers find themselves closer to two goals: to accelerate battery power to an extent that electronic gadgets will have to be recharged only once a week, and to make an electronic vehicle that can travel 6 times more without a recharge. The rechargeable batteries are based on a reaction between two chemicals and their reverse reaction. The cycle of reactions initiated by electric current produce and store charge. China is banning children from playing online games for more than 3 hours a week. This is the hardest restriction so far on the gaming industry as Chinese regulators continue cracking down on a technology sector. Minors in China can only play games between 8 p.m. to 9 p.m. on Fridays, weekends and other public holidays starting from September 1st. This is a notice from the National Press and Publication Administration. Singapore headquarters sees Shopee has launched a recruitment campaign for vendors to sell on what it is called as Shopee India, and it is wrapping up hiring in the country according to YouTube videos and job postings. Shopee is coming to India announces a video posted earlier in August that promises free shipping and no commission fees for sellers and buyers, which link to a recruiting form for sellers. While Sea has a team in India, it does not currently offer e-commerce services in the country. Shopee posted a slew of Indian job advertisements in the recent weeks for position ranging from seller operation to compliance, but has not launched a localized app or website. Infinix Hot 11 and Hot 11S has appeared on the Google Play console. Infinix Hot 11S is already confirmed to ship with a MediaTek Helio G88 processor and up to 128GB of storage. Infinix Hot 11 and Hot 11S launch date is yet to be revealed. Samsung announced a One UI 4 beta program at the end of July. It is almost ready to open up the software to public testing. The community manager in the Samsung forums posted that a beta testing will start in September. But the company has not committed to a specific date, and the beta will be available in South Korea first. Thanks for watching this video. Please kindly support my channel by giving a like, share and subscribe. And follow Digi Integrity on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook.